Well, the future of Queensland's Labor government is on very shaky ground after huge swings against the party in two key state by-elections. It was a proper bloodbath. For more, we're joined by Queensland opposition leader David Crisafulli in Brisbane. Am I talking to the next Premier of Queensland, David?
Good morning, Sarah. No, we're certainly not getting ahead of ourselves, and I really want Queenslanders to appreciate that the mountainous task that lies ahead for us is huge, and we're still chasing a massive task to win the next election. But in terms of these by-elections, we asked Queenslanders to send the government a message, and they did that. And the message is they don't trust them to fix the challenges that they're facing: youth crime, health, housing, cost of living. And they want us to keep going and focus on those issues. But I can assure you, we remain firmly the underdog, and we redouble our efforts to show Queenslanders there's a better way than what they're getting at the moment.
Oh, I mean, we're talking about massive double-digit swings in both by-elections. You snatched the one safe seat for Labor of Ipswich West. Labor retained the working-class seat of Inala Just, Anastasia Palaszczuk's old seat. Queenslanders are making their votes count. I mean, you must be preparing.
History shows that that doesn't correlate. It doesn't just transfer. We've got to earn people's respect and their trust. Now, the Labor Party just expect Queenslanders to keep voting for them. And I just want to give your viewers an insight into how big the task is that we face. We need to win more than a dozen seats. And of the last 12 general elections in Queensland, the Labor Party have won 11. So let me be clear. When I say we're the underdog, we remain the underdog. But what we are is united and focused and disciplined. And the government, in the other case, is wrecked by chaos and crisis at the moment, and there's infighting, and they're not focused on the things that matter to Queenslanders. Mm. But I can tell you, standing on those polling booths on Saturday, no one was talking about political margins or swings or premiers. They were talking about the issues that face them. And in Queensland at the moment, we've got ambulance ramping at 43%, which is the worst in the country. We've got our repeat young offenders that's gone from 10 to 20%, and police numbers have gone back. That's the worst in the country. In terms of housing, there's 43,074 Queenslanders on the waiting list, and we have the lowest home ownership rate in the country. And with electricity, we've had a 19.9% rise in the last 12 months, three times the national average. Yeah. That's what Queenslanders are focused on, not my political fortunes.
I mean, Stephen Miles is saying it'll take more than 3 months to turn things around. He's conceding his predecessor obviously didn't do enough. Can you offer the people of Queensland a viable alternative? Youth crime, cost of living, what will be your first course of action when you take office?
We can. Firstly, it's been the same people for the last decade and things have declined across all four of those. But I can assure Queenslanders within 100 days of the election, they will see what's happening in their hospitals in real time. Doctors and nurses will be in charge. We will rewrite the Youth Justice Act this calendar year and remove detention as a last resort. We're going to implement a maintenance guarantee with our power plants to drive down power prices and keep the lights on in this state. And when it comes to housing, ministers are going to be held accountable to build social housing on time and on budget. And we're going to work with councils to deliver infrastructure immediately to open up more lots to get young kids in the market.
We are serious about this.
Yeah.
Just quickly, because we are running out of time, David, what do you make of these constant redevelopment plans we're talking about for Brisbane 2032? I mean, are you for the Victoria Park redevelopment?
It's a complete mess, and the government's had 1,000 days and they're scrambling. And what I got out of this review is we were told the Gabba was $1 billion and then $2.7 billion. And now one person has found out in 60 days that it's actually $3.4 billion, and Queenslanders were never told. I want the Olympics, and Queenslanders want the Olympics, to be about generational infrastructure. Road, rail, a 20-year tourism plan for the state, having the most accessible cities as part of the Paralympic Games, a telecommunication strategy for disasters. That's got to be the focus of the Olympics, not sporting stadiums and parties for the rich and famous.
Yeah, there's a lot to take care of, David. Thanks for joining us this morning. Welcome back. Well, Queensland's Labor Party is licking its wounds this morning after suffering huge swings against the party in two key state by-elections. Joining us to discuss today's headlines is Tasmanian Senator Jacqui Lambie and a current affair reporter, Neil Breen. Thank you both
for your time
this morning. Jacqui, voters have sent a strong message to the current government. They want to see change.
Yes, they do want to see change. There is quite a lot going up there in Queensland. So I would imagine if this is any indication of what it's going to look like, is their election in October, November, is that it's going to be an absolute wipeout for the Labor Party. So I'm not sure what they're going to do here, but, you know, 6 months is not that far away when you look at it like that. And I think they're in a lot of trouble to retain that state. There is no doubt about it.
I mean, Neil, this is a proper political bloodbath. We're seeing swings of more than 20%.
It's enormous. Labor heartland, Ipswich and Nala, those two seats, like there was the Palaszczuk seat was up for grabs too, and they retained that, but they had to because there needed to be a swing of 30%. But to lose Ipswich West like that is really big. Stephen Miles is no chance of winning later in the year. There would have to be a major scandal on the other side of politics could be the only thing that could save him. But it's been a stale government and a government out of ideas for many years. And then the youth crime crisis, cost of living, the Olympics is on the nose, the total lack of direction, the union influence, the heavy union influence. They've been the most unaccountable government I've seen in 3.5 decades as a journalist. I cannot believe they've gotten away with
Victorian government's almost just as bad as that. And they still
just don't answer questions, just don't front up, just don't deal with anything. And the public's decided that they don't want to cop it anymore. Mm.
Jacqui, do you reckon this will have an impact on the federal election? I mean, I know it's not exactly 8 months away, but surely this will have repercussions.
I think when you start seeing, results like this, this early on in the year, in one state, then I would be, you know, if I was the Federal Labor Party, I'd be watching very, very carefully and being very careful what you do over the next 12 months. Because if this is in any indication of what it's going to look like next May, they're in serious trouble. So, you know, it is mostly Labor states down there. The last stronghold with the Liberals at this point in time is Tasmania. I don't expect them to hold that after Saturday at all. You know, they'll have a balance of power of independence and hopefully the Jacqui Lambie network in there. But seriously, we have... I think that the Federal Labor Party is going to start finding itself into trouble 12 months out from their election. There is no doubt about that.